Even 1 millennium after the Muslim invaders came to India, the Hindus, still unable to find anything appealing or worthwhile in Islam, were ignoring so much privilege and inducements to convert to Islam. Instead, they were paying the humiliating jizya and other kinds of crushing taxes by doggedly adhering to their ancestral faith. Moreover, many of those who had converted to Islam under various circumstances, including at the point of the sword, were willing to revert to their ancestral religion at the earliest opportunity. Muhammad Shah Tughlaq had enslaved and converted 2 brothers, Harihara and Bukka, from the Deccan in 1326. 10 years later, the Sultan sent them back with an army to the Deccan to control the chaotic situation there. Far away from the capital Delhi, they not only returned to the Hindu fold, but also threw away the Islamic yoke from South India by founding the Vijayanagar Kingdom, which became a powerful Hindu kingdom and a flourishing center of Indian civilization and the greatest impediment against Islamization of South India for over 200 years. When deviant Akbar allowed a free choice in religion, many of the Hindus, earlier converted to Islam by force, reverted to their ancestral faith. Muslim women started marrying Hindu men and embraced Hinduism. In one instance, when Shah Jahan was returning from an expedition to Kashmir, he discovered that Hindu men were marrying Muslim women as a part of social custom, and some of the women had adopted the faith of their Hindu husbands. Shah Jahan declared such promiscuous marriages illegal and ordered his officers to separate the Muslim women from their Hindu husbands. It is no wonder then that Maulana Abul Kalam Azad, the first education minister of independent India, condemned Akbar, terming his tolerant rule as the near suicide of Indian Islam. Instead, he praised the fanatic Sufi master Sheikh Ahmad Sarhindi, who had revolted against Akbar, and urged for the restoration of Hindu persecution.